About Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.
And welcome to the Berks County Kennel Club's program, All About Dogs. Hi, I'm Pat Mock, your host. And this evening, we're going to be talking about our annual match show, which is going to be coming up the beginning of April. So my guests this evening are Eileen Narieka, and she is our match show chairman, and Linda Madeira, who is going to be taking care of the obedience, and Raleigh. So we're going to talk to Eileen first of all and find out what actually a match show is. So what is it?
What is a match show?
Yeah.
All right, well, I think most people have seen regular shows on television at one given point or another.
Well, yeah, and Westminster was just on.
Yes, Westminster was just on.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And the match show is a great opportunity to bring your dogs in a more relaxed atmosphere and get them used to the surroundings and the patterns that they have to do for the various judges. It's all, like I said, the key to it all is it's very relaxed and comfortable in a friendly atmosphere. They will be doing the same thing that they do at a Westminster-type show.
Okay, okay.
And being presented to the judges, they're supposed to be groomed as per their breed. But all in all, it becomes a much more fun event and a great practice event.
Okay,
for the
so
dogs.
It is basically all practice.
It's basically a practice. They don't get any points to a championship, but they get good experience in the real dog show world.
And it's not only for the dogs to get experience, but for the handlers as
Absolutely.
Well, because you may not know. You may not know what you're doing, which is, you know, very common with a person that's basically a newcomer with, you know, they just got this purebred dog and whoever they got it from, the breeder told them that they should really show the dog because it's that good and they show what's a show and they don't know how to set the dog up. We know all the words, whereas they're basically learning a new language. You know, we know everything that we're talking about. It's like people who play golf or people who play tennis. They all know the words, and a newcomer has no idea. So
this is just absolutely ideal for a beginner. And it's great for anyone who
wants
to practice their dogs.
Mm-hmm.
As far as that's concerned, there's no time limitations. Everyone takes their time, and the judges will help explain the procedures and what's going on. So we also do, in addition to confirmation, we'll be doing obedience and rally, and once again, a good learning experience for all. The match show itself at Berks, we make it into a family fun event. It's all the board people on the board and members will be bringing their specialties as far as their super soups, sandwiches, desserts, and that type of thing.
Oh, yeah, our food.
Right. And we have a world-famous raffle table with all sorts of items, not just for dogs. There's some people-friendly items, people on the other end of the lead also. So it's a nice way to meet dogs, too, that perhaps you have seen at Westminster.
You know, we haven't told them where it is.
We haven't yet. Okay.
I think that's the main thing. It's local. It's at the 4-H Community Center, out right off Route 183 on County Welfare Road. So it's right near the prison and Berksheim. It's right in that area, the Agricultural Center, if you've been to anything at the Agricultural Center. So it's basically right there. And what's great about it is it's free. There is no admission charge. There is no parking charge. Now, you do have, if you want something to eat, you do have to pay for that. But our prices are very inexpensive. But you do have to pay for any food that you consume. But as far as coming and seeing the dogs, this is a great place to get to know a breed that you just may be interested in. Our judges are very people friendly. If you want to ask the judges questions after they're finished judging, they'd be more than happy to help you, talk to you about it and what it is. Where are our judges from, by the way?
We have some local judges. We have some from Lancaster County and down towards Philadelphia. And it's quite an assortment of judges who have a lot of skills in each of the groups that we'll be showing.
So now, how we're getting these judges, are they AKC accredited, or are the judges practicing as well?
Some of the judges are indeed practicing as well.
Okay.
And some are AKC accredited judges who also enjoy the whole atmosphere, and they get to hone their own skills also at that point in time.
Right.
But as you probably figured out now by the number of times we've used this word, it's a great learning experience for everyone in
a great
relaxed atmosphere.
And it starts what time?
Well, you can come to the day of the show from 8 to 9 for the registration. We have pre-registration if you go on our website, BerksCountyKennelClub.com.
Now, this is only if you want to enter the show.
And if you want to enter the show, pre-enter the show, you can do that until March 28th. And that the confirmation, which is the typical, how does this dog meet the standard that you've seen happening on TV many times, that will be happening first. And then in the afternoon, we will be having obedience and rally. Mm-hmm.
But it's for the spectator. I don't want to enter the show. I want to just come and see dogs.
Time. Welcome all day.
But it starts at what time
eight.
In the morning?
It'll no, be no. open at 8.
The show itself
will be starting at 9.
Okay. And that's with juniors.
And that's with juniors.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah, there is such a thing as junior showmanship, and that's for kids that are what 8
to
17.
8 to 9, 10 to 12, and 13 to 17.
13 to 17, okay.
There's three areas.
Yeah, mm-hmm. yeah. So if your children are possibly interested in showing your dog, if you have a purebred, now we are only going to have purebreds. This is an AKC-sanctioned match, which means we have to go by the AKC rules. So it's only purebreds. In obedience, we'll talk about obedience later, but as far as the confirmation, it must be an AKC registered dog to show. We're not going to have any Labradoodles or Shih Tzus or any of the crossbreeds. They're only going to be purebreds. How does this show run as far as I want to come and see Dalmatians? So how would I know when I should come to see Dalmatians?
Well, since there's going to be varying rings going throughout the day, there's not really a set time to see any particular dog that you might have in mind.
Okay, it's not
like
a point show.
So it might be going to a lot.
We have different groups.
Like yes.
Right, there's different groups.
In one ring, and then a herding group in another ring.
So it would be best to come all day long?
Yes.
Yep. Right? Mm-hmm. So if I get there at, say, 9:30 in the morning, chances are I'd get to see Dalmatians.
That's likely.
Uh-huh. Another thing that's different with a match show as opposed to a point show is that the breeds go in alphabetical order. So if I wanted to see Dalmatians, I would go to the non-sporting ring, and then I would see the Bichons and the Chows and the French Bulldogs
Dalmatians will come before that.
D comes before F. I have to think of my alphabet first.
Don't forget the
Catans. Yeah. Oh, that's right. That's right. The Catans.
That's this little guy.
By the way, that is what she is holding. She is holding a Catan de Tulier.
That's the white one.
Right, the white one. The black one is the Belgian Sheepdog. But we will talk about obedience, and then we'll talk about the different breeds.
Well, this is
So tell us a little bit about obedience, Linda. What are we doing as far as obedience?
Okay, we have novice, open, and utility, and then in the afternoon we will have rally.
Obedience is in the afternoon too, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah, that starts at what? 1 o'clock.
Yeah, or whenever breed is done.
No, I think it starts at 1 o'clock. Doesn't it start at 1 o'clock? Let me check this. Doesn't it start at 1 o'clock? I'm pretty sure it starts at 1 o'clock. She's pointing
after,
to me, but
after breed is finished.
After breed is finished.
After breed is finished. Which is probably going to be
obedience
about 1 o'clock.
And rally is you can enter from 11 to 12 o'clock.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then the obedience is right after breed, but not before 1 o'clock. Mm-hmm. Okay. That's where I got the 1 o'clock.
That gives you time for lunch.
Right. That gives you time for lunch. So
you
can come before lunch and have lunch and then show your dog.
Good.
But if you're like me, you're too nervous to eat before even a match show.
Yep.
But anyhow, so we're going to have the three.
We have three rings.
Okay.
We have, and our judges are relatively local. The ones from Pine Grove or Schuylkill Haven doing open and utility. The rally judges from Allentown area. That was Linda Crazley.
Mm-hmm.
And then Nina Schleck is from Temple, and she'll be doing novice. So they're relatively local, and the rally judge is actually studying to be a judge.
A judge, okay.
Yeah. Yeah. So she actually needs this to qualify.
That's right.
Because we're in a sanctioned match.
Yeah, yeah.
And you can, this is a great place to practice. There's a lot of shows coming up, and you want to practice at a match before you actually waste your money on a show. Right. And see.
And even if you don't know what obedience is, it's really helpful to come and watch. You know, what is obedience? I don't know what obedience is. Well, if you come and you watch what obedience is, and you say, gee, I might like to do that with my dog. Everybody says obedience, obedience. But for
starting out,
coming out to an obedience show, you will actually see what the dogs have to do. You know, they have different criteria for each one of the classes. So a beginner would enter the novice class, obviously. And that's really basic obedience. You know, your dog heels, your dog sits, your dog lays down, your dog stays, your dog comes when you call. Then you get up a little bit higher with your open work, and that's what, retrieving the dumbbell and
drop on recall,
uh-huh.
Retrieving the dumbbell, jumping over jumps, and then there's the utility, which is scent work. I mean, scent articles,
yeah.
and it's quite
direct. That's directed jumping.
Directed jumping,
sending the dog away and directed jumping. Yeah.
There's a lot involved in it,
uh-huh.
But you start out with a novice group,
right,
novice
right.
class. And rally is basically obedience with your dog doing all the different entities and you reading signs and following directions without a judge actually telling you what to do. You have to read the signs and know what the signs mean.
Okay. So you follow the numbers and then read the signs,
yeah,
right?
Yep.
Right. And what's nice about rally is that
you can talk to your dog
throughout all of the exercises. You have to talk to your dog.
You can encourage.
That's one of the requirements, right?
Yes, you can encourage them all along and keeps their attention, which you can't really do that when you get to the
right.
other obedience
right.
things. So rally is a good place to
get
really bonded with your dog.
Mm-hmm. And that starts at the same time, 1 o'clock.
Yes.
We're running the obedience and the rally at the same time.
Yes.
And that too has different levels.
Yes, it does. It goes from
right.
novice to excellent.
To advanced and excellent, right?
Yep.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
They're named a little differently, but they're all basically, you know, each one gets a little more difficult. So how about we talk about some of the breeds? You have a Catan. You want to put...
Sure.
This way you get to see what the breed looks like.
This little fella, who's going to lay down anyway?
Well, actually, we're not going to see how big they are. This is a very small grooming table that the dog is on.
Let me see if I can make him stand up. There he is.
And it's yeah.
Okay.
There
this
you
is
go.
A Coton de Tulliar. The Coton de Tulliar's origin is Madagascar, but the French wrote the standard for this little dog, and he is purebred dog. They're recognized in the non-sporting group. We're a dog that's known basically for coat, but he definitely is in a puppy cut. This is just a little fun guy that plays around the house. And this coat is supposed to have a nice cottony texture.
That's why they're called Catans, right? Which is cotton.
Catan,
right?
So, friendly yeah. little, you know, a little dog who will be a great companion to you, but don't underestimate them. They excel at agility and obedience. We have them lure coursing. They're doing just about everything, including
wow.
doggy dancing, freestyle doggy dancing, which is really adorable.
Yeah. Oh, it's such a little dog. You know, it can easily go between your legs.
Yes,
you know.
It can.
Uh-huh. Now, do they come in different colors, or do they come in only the white?
A Catan by standard is the overall appearance of a white dog. We can have a minimal amount of coloring, but the overall appearance should be a white dog.
Okay.
Puppies
okay.
are sometimes born with color, but that fades.
Okay. Now, how long a coat does this dog usually
It will be get? To the ground.
To the ground?
It would be to the okay. ground if he was in full coat.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
And that requires a fair amount of grooming because it is
oh,
so soft.
Yes, it does.
It does.
Is this the coat that you would usually cut a non-show dog?
I yes.
mean, once you're finished uh-huh. showing, you cut your dogs down, right?
Right.
I mean, you certainly don't want this long coat that you're going to have to be brushing every single day of the week, which I assume.
And washing.
Right. And
this is typical puppy coat. And of course, and if they're shown in any obedience, agility, or those types of disciplines, they're cut. Like this.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Just like this.
Okay. Very good.
Okay.
And then we'll talk about your dog, Linda.
Okay.
Now, you don't really need to hop up on the
table.
it's just a little too small for your breed.
Yeah. We
so get up. You have
you can stand up. Where should I go? A Belgian sheepdog.
Come right front.
Okay. Say she's an 8-month-old. Well, she'll be 8 months old tomorrow. Belgian sheepdog.
Mm-hmm.
And
can you set her up for us?
Sure. Come on. Paisley, sit. Come on. Paisley, stand. Good girl. Come, come, come. Good stand. That's good. Fix your feet. Good stay.
And that's basically all you do with this breed. You don't hold their tails up. Like some of the breeds you see at Westminster, they hold the tails up, especially like with the hunting dogs. You don't hold his tail up.
No. Okay. I want the tail down.
You want the tail down.
I want the tail down.
Now, they
she can free bait.
Oh, okay. Okay, that's what you're doing there.
So no free baiting, yeah.
Okay.
Good. Yeah.
Okay.
Belgians should set themselves up. If they're a good good standard and good stand up. They should be able to step themselves up. Stand up.
She don't want to stand.
Stand
she's
up.
Done standing.
Stand
she's
up.
Gonna sit and
stand up.
She's an obedience dog.
She is. She's doing obedience.
You don't have any good food, so she's going to sit.
No food at all. Yeah, my obedience dog is out. My rally dog is outside.
Yeah.
We'll switch.
Okay. Jack, would you like to bring the chin in?
Come here. We'll take you back. Come on, Timber. Paisley, come. Be quiet. You're making too much noise.
Now, this is a Japanese chin. I don't know why they call them Japanese chins when they don't have any chin. So what does chin actually mean? And why do they call it that? I know the dog is from Japan, right?
It's from Japan. Why a chin? I don't know. Up until the 80s, it was a Japanese spaniel.
Oh, okay. So they don't have really any muzzle at all, do they?
No, they're supposed to have a very flat face with a domed head.
Oh, okay.
And they're the only breed that is allowed to have white in their showing in their eyes. That's desirable.
Really?
Really.
Huh, how about that? So then this is a toy breed as well. This breed is shown in the toy group as opposed to the Catan, which is in the non-sporting. Although it's a little dog, it's still, you know. Now, what other colors does this come in?
This comes in red and white.
Uh-huh.
And sable and white.
Okay.
And tricolor.
Okay. Now, the sable and white is what color?
Sable is sort of a red, can be a buff to an Irish setter, but it has to have black tips on the
Okay, color. Almost like a fox color.
Yes.
Oh, okay. You know, sable, you think of, when I think of a sable coat mm-hmm. is black. But in dogs, a sable is not black, but it's colored brown.
It's colored with black tips on the fur.
Okay. And the red is like an Irish setter, right?
From a buff to an Irish setter.
Oh, okay. So it's really a wide range of colors mm-hmm. then, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Wow, okay. So now what actually was this dog bred for?
Companions to the Japanese emperors. It was a court dog.
Oh, okay.
And wasn't known to the Western world until Admiral Perry opened up Japan, and the Emperor of Japan gave chin to be taken back to the President of the United States and Queen Victoria, and that was the first introduction to the Western world.
Wow!
Even though the breed's over a 1,000 years old.
Huh? They almost look like Pekingese with the.
It's that same family of Pekingese pug. They all go back to
Okay. All right. Very good. Now she's entered in. He's entered in the show on the Sunday. You'll be able to see other chins there.
There might be other chins there.
Okay.
He won't be entered.
Okay.
Because
okay.
I'm
you're judging. Right. Yeah. When you're judging, you're a little bit too busy to show your own dog. Right.
But
this is one of our judges, by the way.
Will be entered Sunday at the York shows.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's a long weekend. That
will be his first show.
Oh, okay. And how old is he?
He is 10 months.
Wow. So he's basically full grown though. With the toys, they're full grown by 10 months old. Yeah. With the like you saw Linda's dog, that's not nearly a half full grown yet.
And they're very quiet, calm dogs.
Oh, very. Okay. Well, that wouldn't work in my household. Well, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
And we'll have Dave come in. Okay, and this is an Australian. Did you want to put her? Would she fit on the table or not?
Ooh, we could try her.
Not the normal table breed.
No, huh? It's not the normal table breed, but we'll be able to see her better, won't we? Yes, we will. Say, oh, phooey, I don't want to. She can sit on that. There you go. There you go. That way we can see her better. Now, look at the camera. That's a good girl. You look at the camera. Now, this is an Australian Shepherd. Okay. It does do shepherdy work. It does herding.
She is herded.
Okay, okay.
Herded sheep.
Okay.
And she's done agility. That was her main job with me.
Uh-huh.
She's done obedience. She's done rally. She has done some confirmation.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
She's 12 years old. And if some of you read the Reading Eagle, you might have seen her in the... Reading Eagle, when they had Westminster Agility, she was in the paper that day, and we retired her at Westminster Agility this year.
Oh, isn't that nice? Wow.
She had one clean round there and one round where she just kind of went,
we're going to have a good time. This is our retirement party.
Yeah, it was a very tough course. And
so you people would... The people with older dogs, they say, oh, the dog's getting old. But, I mean, at 12 years old, look at how agile she is yet. She's still so full of life. And people say, oh, well, this, you know, the poor dog, you know, it's retired and, you know, it just lays around the house. That's because you let the dog lay around the house.
Yeah, and she's never really been overweight. I mean, she looks big, but this is
all hair. Yes. That's exactly right.
She's in very good shape from doing agility. The one problem that... she's having right now is her hearing is kind of going away
a little bit. Just like an old person.
Yeah.
But her eyesight, her eyes look good. Her eyes look nice and clear. And if she can see the jumps, obviously she's not having any eye problems.
Right.
Very good.
So we had fun there.
That's good. Very good. So this is our Westminster dog. Yeah. Our Westminster. This was the first year they did rally, wasn't it? Or is this the second year?
It was the third year for
agility. Okay, okay.
Yeah.
I guess it was the first year for obedience.
Okay. And
I know it was the first for something.
We understand that Fox Sports is signed for the next 10 years of Westminster Agility.
Oh, my gosh. So, well, it's exciting to watch. Agility is really exciting to watch. Everybody loves to see the dogs run and jump and follow directions. Like, you know... The dogs at home don't follow any directions, and then they get in the agility ring, and you actually see what they can do.
Well, and they're trained.
That's exactly right, and they love it. That's the good thing. They love it.
And if she didn't love it, I wouldn't have kept doing it with her for as long as I did.
Right, right. So. Okay. Well, thank you very much, and we have Linda back again.
Candy,
and she has her obedience dog with her. We won't put her on the table. Okay.
Timber's doing rally.
Timber's doing rally? Okay, yeah, so Timber then she's rally. Entered on she, Sunday.
Yes.
She will be entered at
she will
the
be
show.
Entered. She,
okay.
She has her rally novice and one leg in rally advanced.
Oh, okay. So you're going to be practicing the advanced then.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Very good, very good.
Her mother finished all three titles this year.
Wonderful.
And she's 9 years old.
Wow.
And she finished her companion dog title. So she got four titles in just a couple months, and she's
So
we do work old dogs.
Yep, that's exactly right. We don't let dogs retire.
No, we keep them working.
We keep working, and they keep working.
She had plenty of energy left over after having four litters, and she wasn't ready to quit yet. So I said, "Let's go do something
else." That's exactly right. So older dogs can do a lot in
Timber.
And this is one of the things that you might want to go and see when you do go to the mat show, and it's free, so. You know, why not? Why not go and see the dogs? Before you touch a dog, though, please ask. Because some dogs are not child-friendly. Some dogs, you're not quite sure whether they're going in the ring right now or not. So you don't want to be petting a dog and messing up the coat when they're going to be going in the ring in 2 seconds. So just ask, especially with your children. No carriages, no baby carriages. There's just not enough room for that. But like I said, it's at the 4-H Community Center. It's April the 3rd, which is a Sunday, and it starts at 9:30 in the morning, and it will go all day long. So you can get food. We have raffles, and so have a nice day and come on out. Okay, we'll see you April the 3rd for this evening. Good night.
On BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.